first time you look at a DVD, if you want to know how to play it, there are four basic steps. The first one is the vibration of the lips. If you were to vibrate lips like this, nice and soft raspberry, you'll get a sound like this out of this, or like this wood. That's where you need number two come into play. A little bit hard step, but if you understand how to do circular breathing like this, take the air into your nose, or down your stomach, and out through your mouth. Like this. Now there's two types of circular breathing. That one was the long one. Short one. Number two, is taking the air into your nose, all the way down to here, and like so. Short one. Long one. By using these two types of technique, you will be able to determine the tempo of the sound of the instrument. Whereas slow, down, you do the long one. Short one. Once you understand these two types of technique with the vibration of the lips, now you need rhythm. And rhythm usually comes from your tongue. By sticking your tongue in and out of your mouth, like this, in this hollow piece of wood, doing the other two steps, you get something like this. English dictionary under the heading onomatopoeia. It means what it sounds like, the didgeridoo. Of course, we had 40 different languages to this instrument. In the Cadbrook region up the top, they call it Igigigi, which means ancestry voice. Then you've got Iriki, Idaki, where Urukawa is situated in the northeast Arnhem Land. That's what they call this instrument. Other places like West Australia, the Northern Territory, Gurmul Gangla, Magtok, Ian, and Bilbil. These are some of the language names for this instrument. There's 40 different languages. Now there's 42. The didgeridoo, and the southern people in the southern part of Australia will call it a piece of wood. So 42 different languages. So once you get that organized, the first step, circular breathing, and the rhythm, there's a fourth one. This is the way we talk. By throwing our voices in this hollow piece of wood, we can mimic any type of sound. For example, the dingo. Well, the dingo only arrived in my country, in West Australia, which was the last 20,000 years ago or so. And came from the Asian people. We did a lot of training in West Australia and Aboriginal. The dingo, when he came across, he had a very soft voice, was able to adapt to country, and he didn't bark and howl, and we took him in as a happy dog. So, you like to mimic him through this one, and get out like this. So trying these voices in this whole piece of wood, you get it. Then you get bird sounds, like kookaburra. Kookaburra. So, by using those two top steps, you can create music. Also, different parts of your body play different sounds. Because the body's like a chamber orchestra. You play from your stomach, you get a very deep sound like this. If you play from the top of your head, you get a dull sound, a higher pitch. So you get higher and lower notes. But cutting the different sizes, shorter the ditch, the higher the pitches, the longer the ditch, the more deeper the pitches, because the vibration takes a long time for it to come from one end of the water to the other. End of the day.